and this is the much talked about Hydrogen Rebalance update. I've not been around for a bit because I've had COVID-19, but I'm recovering quite quickly, so that's good. Anyway, so hydrogen used to be a bit of a pain. Used to be that you had to refuel your ships a lot more. We had to deal with hydrogen engines were not viable at all. They were only used for recharging batteries, if that. But hydrogen has had a rebalance. Now, the rebalance for hydrogen, blimey, a plane, that's something I haven't heard for a while. So, let's look at this big tank, shall we? I'm going to post a link to some of the posts from Reddit about the hydrogen rebalance in the description of this video. But if you look, we now have a huge capacity for large grid hydrogen tanks. It was originally something like 5 million. It's now something like 15 million. So there's a lot of hydrogen that can be stored in there. And if you're running hydrogen and oxygen generators into a system like this, you can actually produce a lot more. How much more? Well, O2H2 generators now use half the amount of ice per second and produce twice as much hydrogen per unit of ice. This means I can run this test rig here without using these hydrogen generators. I can burn about 2 units of hydrogen per minute. But if I put these hydrogen generators on, I can run this hydrogen engine at full thrust for quite a while. And it's not just the hydrogen generators that have been rebalanced, but even the hydrogen engine itself has been rebalanced. Basically, what they've done is they've reduced the hydrogen engine capacity to balance against the regular hydrogen tanks, and there were small tanks introduced in the Frostbite update. Basically, hydrogen engines only consume half as much hydrogen per watt produced. So, they're now quite viable. What I've got here, though, is a little test rig. And just to give you an idea about what we've got here, is a hydrogen thruster. You see it? And I'm going to fire it for a bit. So what we're going to do is we're going to fire this hydrogen thruster. You see it there. Burning away. Have a look at the hydrogen display. It'll take about a minute to burn 2 units of hydrogen. So if you've got a hydrogen powered ship now, if you've got one of those with numerous O2H2 generators and large tanks and so on and so forth, you can actually get more bang for your buck, as they say. You'll be able to do quite a lot with a hydrogen powered ship. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw the 2 O2 generators on. So they're now feeding hydrogen back into the system. It'll still consume hydrogen, because you're firing a hydrogen thruster off a single large tank of 15 million units. But in the old days, prior to the hydrogen rebalance, that 97 would be much lower. I can't show you how lower because, of course, I don't have the previous version patch installed. A lot has changed on Space Engineers, and a lot is going to change. I mean, we have mods now on the retail. I'll be doing another video on the basics of mods. There's a few more videos coming, including one which will cover not only the basics of mods, but somebody asked me about jump drives. So I wanted to do a very, very basic jump drive tutorial. There's a few misconceptions about them, and I wanted to clear that up. But for now, witness that this is actually not burning as much hydrogen as it used to. And over here, we have our hydrogen engine. It's linked up to two generators here just to refill, but they're off. So your hydrogen engine is currently off. But this will not consume ice like there's no tomorrow. If I turn this on, here it goes. And in the old days of Space Engineers, those people who used hydrogen engines will have watched that hydrogen drop off rapidly, watched all of their ice in this cargo container going down at an alarming rate. You bear in mind, none of these generators are on, so this is just purely using hydrogen from hydrogen engine, and it will stay on a lot longer. You can leave that running to recharge any batteries you might have, and so on and so forth. And as I said, the prime sort of reason for this video was to get it out the way, talk about the hydrogen rebalance, explain that the thrusters themselves haven't been improved. What's been improved is the way that hydrogen is produced and hydrogen is stored, which means you're not losing overly much. Let's turn that off for now. So you can use a hydrogen engine with a few O2 generators and some ice to get a good recharge on a ship's systems, or on a base even. You could make a recharge station if you're sitting, like many people do on Earth, like at a large ice lake, or on Mars at an ice cap. You can see that this engine is still burning away quite nicely, and it's only consumed that much of your hydrogen. And by now, potentially on a big thruster like that, on a small ship with a, or on a ship with a tank like that, you'd be off into space. I've got the Talium Explorer, which has two of these tanks and a bunch of hydrogen thrusters, and since the rebalance, that's been quite an efficient ship. I'm lucky though in that regard, because I'm on a Earth-like with lots of ice, and out in space is another source of ice, which is a giant ice asteroid. I don't have the Talium Explorer on this particular save, though. So there you go. That's hydrogen. How much it's changed. And, well, there you have it. I'll catch you in the next one. Stay safe. Take care. Have fun. Happy engineering. Bye for now.